Welcome to Singing with Ron!
Hello, and welcome to this video on singing and singing exercises for people with Parkinson's. I just want to state from the beginning that I'm a voice teacher. I'm not a speech pathologist or anything like that. So I'm just giving some what I have found to work with my students who have Parkinson's exercises that that I've found have really worked for them. So that being said, there's been a lot of research done over the last few years about singing and the voice and what singing can do for people with Parkinson's, and so I'm starting to see that in my own studio. I have a couple of students now that have Parkinson's and come because they love to sing, and but also it allows them to work on their voice and to keep their voice working. So when they sing every day, their voice is wonderfully present and audible. So I'm just going to run you through and explain as I go why I'm doing things so that you understand. So the first thing I want you to think about is your posture. If you sit up straight or standing, you can do the standing. It keeps those muscles engaged in your body, but then also your voice just works a lot better when you have good posture and when you don't have good posture. So thinking up with your posture. So the first exercise I want you to do is to breathe out on a and try to do that for as long as possible. So 15 seconds is a good amount of time, but see if you can slowly start extending that to 30 seconds. I can go for quite a while. But basically, singing and speaking is allowing your breath to come out slowly. When we take in normal breathing, we just kind of breathe in. And when we breathe out, all our air escapes very slowly or very quickly. But when we speak and when we sing, our air, we have to engage muscles in our abs so that we can breathe out very, very slowly. And that what that does is engage those muscles in your abs. So you got your rectus abdominis, your obliques, and your transverse abdominis. And all of those things will engage while you do it. One variation is to lift up your arms and try the exercise and see if that gives you a little bit of extra time on the old stopwatch. Good. So that's the first exercise. The next exercise that I do is I get people to reach up and go s-s-s quite forcefully. S-s-s, and you'll feel your belly and your abs squeezing. Then lean to one side. This engages some of your obliques. S-s-s, and lean to the other side. Engaging obliques, and then twist. This engages another set of obliques. And then twist to the other side. And then engages some more obliques. And just lifting up your arms engages your transverse abdominis. Did I get that right? Yes, I did. Good. So so that's a lovely exercise that works on your posture and breathing and strengthening your muscles of core so that you can support your voice. The next exercise that I do with my students is to get them to do glottals. And basically, chest voice is when your vocal folds come together like this, very fully and really well together. And so that sounds like that. And then we've got a lighter way for your vocal folds to come together, and that looks like that. But then a breathy way of your vocal folds to come together, they actually don't come together. And so you have a lot of air coming through. And this is what starts to happen for a lot of students who have Parkinson's. Their vocal folds aren't fully coming together. So to encourage that, if you do so let's go and just try to hit a pitch. It doesn't matter what pitch, if you want to do that pitch. And we'll go and that brings those vocal folds together. You can also breathe in, hold your breath, and then make the glottal sound. So what a glottal is that your vocal folds have come together and then the air brings them apart, but then they come back together in a nice thick way. And so when your vocal folds fully come together, you're louder. So that is a really great exercise for you to be working on. The next exercise that I find really great for people with Parkinson's is yelling. So in singing, we call it belting. And so it's very similar actually to what we were just doing. And what I want you to do is go, yo, yo, yo. And what I want you to do is feel like you're calling somebody to you. Yo. And you can do this with a glottal as well. Oh, or hey. Oh, hey. Ah. And find a vowel that really, that you like the most. Most people like O. Oh. 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 And you can lift your chin a little bit. And smile, oh, so you get those muscles in your face activating, oh, and so yelling really brings your vocal folds together fully. It creates a setup in your vocal tract that just automatically makes you louder, and it works a lot of great and wonderful muscles all through your system, in your abs, your chest is opening up, you're feeling your throat opening up, and something is narrowing. So this takes me to the next exercise. So if I
open up my throat and I get very like Patrick from SpongeBob, or Eeyore, I'm so sad, right? But the opposite of that is, let's say, the Wicked Witch and your little dog, too, yeah? So when you do that, something is narrowing back and making you very nya-nya-nya-nya-nya. So I want you to try this, and we're going to go, let's try it here. Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. So this is an exercise. It kind of make it a little bit nasal and also very twangy. Nya, nya, nya. Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. Think Fran Drescher, yeah? Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. Dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig, dig, dig. So, those are some, that's a really great exercise as well. So, we've covered glottals, yelling, yo, or deyo, deyo,
Daylight come and me wanna go home. Day, me said 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 day. Oh, that's a great one to try. Just to yell. Good. And then adding some twang, some narrowing that creates back pressure back onto your vocal folds and thickens them up so that you can be nice and loud. So to go over as well, your posture, thinking about your posture while you do this, reaching up, engaging your core so you're engaging your breath so you can breathe out nice and slowly. These are all wonderful, wonderful, wonderful ideas that you can do on a daily basis to maybe you can just watch this video over and over. And but if you want more videos, you can go to my website, singingwithron.com. And if you sign up, and you'll just be giving me your email. But when I come out with new videos and there's also, you'll get access to some free mini courses. I have one on posture, one on belting, one on breathing, and another one on semi-occluded vocal tract exercises. So those are all some great, wonderful, free little mini courses that you can play around and discover more things about your voice. Great. Hope you have a good rest of your day.